It's Monday, 24th September, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. Chief Minister Edappadi K. Palaniswamy and his deputy O. Paneerselvam sharply attacked DMK President M. K. Stalin on Saturday as they addressed a meeting organized in connection with the MGR birth centenary celebrations here. He also came down heavily on Amma Makkal Munnetra Kazhagam founder T.T.V. Dinakaran, again without naming him, saying that a traitor who was shunted out by Jalalitha was claiming that the loyalists of MGR and Jalalitha were with him. After listing out achievements of various departments and distribution of welfare measures to the needy under his leadership, Mr. Palaniswamy said the AIADMK rule in Tamil Nadu had taken path-breaking steps in the fields of education, healthcare, industrial investment, employment generation, and law and order, and had obtained favorable orders in the prolonged legal battle in the Kaveri water dispute. He announced that the number of seats in the Kanyakumari Government Medical College would be increased from 100 to 150 from the next academic year, and radiological investigation equipment, a catheterization lab, and 5 dialysis units, all at the cost of Rs 12.74 crore, would be procured shortly. Health Minister C. Vijaya Bhaskar launched a new health cover scheme that combines the Chief Minister's Comprehensive Health Insurance Scheme, CMCHIS, with the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. The latter was launched by the Prime Minister on Sunday all over the country. The scheme provides enhanced free insurance coverage of up to Rs. 5 lakh per family per year to all beneficiaries. The minister had also signed an MOU with the Government of India officials to implement the Ayushman Bharat scheme in association with the CMCHIS. All high-end procedures like cochlear implantation, liver, bone marrow, stem cell, renal, heart and lung transplants, and auditory brainstem implant of up to Rs. 25 lakh would be continued to be provided to all beneficiaries covered under the corpus fund of the CMCHIS, the release said. US Ambassador to the UN Nikki Haley has urged Iran to look in the mirror for the causes of an attack on a military parade that killed at least 29 people on Saturday. Ms. Haley said Iranian President Hassan Rouhani had oppressed his people for a long time. She was responding to Mr. Rouhani's fierce criticism of the US, in which he blamed it for enabling the attack. Two separate groups have claimed that they carried out the shooting, but neither has provided the evidence. Four gunmen opened fire at the Revolutionary Guard troops in the southwestern city of Ahvaz on Saturday, killing 29 people, including soldiers and civilians, watching a commemorative parade. Mr. Rouhani said the bully US, along with the Gulf states it backed, had enabled the attack. But the US has denied responsibility and says it condemns any terrorist attack, while a senior official for the United Arab Emirates, one of the countries Mr. Rouhani was thought to be referring to, called the accusations baseless. Mr. Rouhani will face US President Donald Trump at the UN General Assembly this week. Solar policy with the Tamil Nadu Energy Development Agency, or TEDA, the state nodal agency for renewable energy, putting out the draft of the Tamil Nadu Solar Energy Policy 2018 for comments from various stakeholders. It envisages various incentives for energy generation and aims to promote manufacture of solar energy components, including solar cells, inverters, mounting structures, and batteries in the state. According to the draft policy, solar energy will be a major contributor to sustainable energy future in Tamil Nadu and will be the mainstream energy source in the state by 2022. The draft policy also mandates that some definite goals, like all public buildings, will be mandated to meet 30% of their energy requirements from solar energy by 2022. Street lights and water supply are mandated to meet 30% of their energy requirements from solar energy as well. The police sounded high alert in Andhra Pradesh and on the state borders following the killing of Arakku MLA Kidari Sarveswara Rao and former MLA Siveri Soma on Sunday. Chief Minister N. Chandrababu Naidu, who was on a US trip, called Vishakhapatnam collector and SP over phone and inquired about the incident. He reviewed the situation and directed the officials to take measures to maintain law and order. Public representatives who were in the Maoist hit list were asked not to go into Naxal-dominated areas without giving prior notice to the police. Srikakulam SP C.M. Verma also reviewed the situation along the border of the district. All the vehicles moving on AP-Odisha routes were being checked at various places including Guma Lakshmipuram, Komarada, Salur, Sitampet and other areas. We round up this newscast with fuel prices and key metros. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 85.87 rupees per litre and diesel for 78.20 rupees per litre. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 82.61 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.97 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 89.97 rupees per litre and diesel for 78.53 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 84.44 rupees per litre and diesel for 75.82 rupees per litre.